School for Yours, Visual C++, 2010 Help Video Number 2, Embedding YouTube Videos. When embedding the YouTube video, please change the link of the video. For example, we have a link here for one of the videos on YouTube, and we need to modify the link by placing a slash where the equal sign is and removing a watch question mark. So this link should now become this link. The code used within this video can be downloaded at schoolforyour.com, and links to the YouTube videos used are found in this video's description. In this tutorial, we'll use Visual C++ 2010 Express running on Windows 7 Service Pack 1. I'll start by making a new project. I'll select Windows Forms Application. The name of this project will be CPP_YT example. Go ahead and click OK. I'll resize the form. I'll go to the toolbox and scroll down to components. If I don't have the Shockwave Flash object, I need to load that into the toolbox by right mouse clicking on components, selecting choose items, then clicking on the COM Components tab. I'll scroll down until I find Shockwave Flash Object. I'll check the box next to Shockwave Flash Object. Click on OK. And now I can go ahead and use the Shockwave Flash Object within the form. I'll just drag and drop and resize how I wish. I'll then go to the properties of the Shockwave Flash Object. Scroll down to where we have Movie. And this is where I put in the link. So I'll go to YouTube, and here I have a video that I wish to add. So I'll just copy the video link up there at the top, go back to Visual C++, and paste within the movie area. Next, I have to modify the link, removing the equal sign and placing a slash, and then deleting watch question mark. The video loads. If I wish to, I can resize a little bit. The YouTube video will resize itself to the size of the Shockwave Flash object. Let's go ahead and run it this time. And now I can go ahead and play the video. I'll go ahead and stop. And I'll close down Form 1. I've made four buttons on the form to illustrate that you can change the YouTube video within the Shockwave Flash object. The names of the buttons are simply button 1, button 2, button 3, and button 4. So I'll start with the crayfish. Even though the crayfish is the default for the Shockwave Flash object, what I'll do is I'll just go to YouTube, and I have the crayfish video right here. I'll copy. Double click on the button and add the code. AX Shockwave Flash 1 arrow operator capital movie equals, then within quotation mark, I'll paste the link in, close quotation and semicolon. I have to remember to change the link. So we'll remove the equal sign and place a slash where the equal sign used to be, and then delete watch. So that's one video done. I'll go get the moon video. I'll go to YouTube. Here I have the moon video all set. Right mouse click, copy the link, go back to C++. Under design, double click on the moon button, which is button 2. And then I'll add the code AX Shockwave Flash 1 arrow operator movie equals, and then within quotation, the link ending with a semicolon equal becomes a slash, and delete watch question mark. Now for the Visual C++ 2010 tutorial 1, go to YouTube, copy the link, Go back to C++, under design, double click on the button, I wish. Enter in the code, AX shockwave, flash, one, movie, equals, within quotation, the link, removing the equal sign with a slash, and deleting watch question mark. Okay, last one, the cat video. Back to YouTube. Here's the cat video. Copy the link. Back to C++. I'll double click on the button. AX shockwave. Flash. One. Movie. Equals within quotation the link. Ending with a semicolon. And here, be very careful, there is a underscore. I don't want to delete the underscore. I just want to remove the equal sign and place the slash and delete watch question mark. Okay, I'll go ahead and run. Prairie Crayfish is all set to run. As a default, I click on Moon. Moon loads. Visual C++ 2010. Cat video. And back to Crayfish. If I wish to play one of these, I can go ahead, load it, and then play as I normally would with any YouTube video.